This video is for the French 1 Unit 7 vocabulary list. You should have your vocab list with you and out, ready to take notes and make notes of pronunciation as is needed. So let's get started. Le serveur. That is our masculine form. La serveuse. And that is our feminine form. Table pour. La carte. Spécial du jour. Qu'est-ce que vous recommandez? Je recommande. Avez-vous? Ça coûte combien? Ça coûte. Voudriez-vous? La cuisine. Végétarien. That would be your masculine form. Végétarienne is your feminine form. Quoi et donc? That. Ça a. Avec. Appréciez votre repas. Bon appétit. Hors d'oeuvre. L'entrée. Le dessert. On this one, it is very important that you get this double S sound here, le dessert, to make sure that you're distinguishing it from le désert, which is spelled with one S, which is desert. Autre chose. Comment est votre nourriture? Now, if you'll notice the things that we've been going over, we've been with this here and with the votre nourriture and voudriez-vous, avez-vous? Okay, we're talking about food, but you would use these sentences when you're in a restaurant. And in a restaurant, speaking with a server, you're going to use vous. You're not going to use tu. So that's why all of these are with the vous form. And I'm not giving you an option of the tu form, because you're not going to use that when you're in a restaurant, and the server, when they're speaking to you, is not going to use to form. They're going to use vous with you. So now we're down to this one. Est-ce que ça va? Délicieux. That is our masculine form. Délicieuse is our feminine form. Bon and mauvais. Le meilleur, that is your masculine singular, and la meilleure is your feminine. You notice that both of these words, meilleur and meilleur, are pronounced the same, which is why it's important that you have this definite article in front of it that distinguishes whether it is masculine or feminine. Le pire, and la pierre. Again, you distinguish with your definite article that you have before it as to whether it is masculine or feminine. Apportez-moi. L'addition. Dollar. Centime. Les espèces. La carte de crédit. La pourboire. La cuillère. Le couteau. La fourchette. L'assiette. Le bol. La serviette. Now, la serviette could be used for a napkin, but it could also be used for a towel, which is why that they're kind of similar, because if you think about it, a napkin is like a towel for your mouth kind of thing. La tasse. La verre. La nourriture. La soupe. La salade. La viande. Le steak. Le hamburger. Le sandwich. Le pain. La baguette. Le beurre. Le fromage. Le bœuf. Le poulet. Le poisson. Again, very critical that you get that S sound, poisson, because when there's one S and it's poison, you're talking about poison. Very different from fish. Le porc. La dinde. Le jambon. Le saucisson. Les œufs. Now that's your plural, that's eggs. For singular, it'd be un œuf. Un œuf. You have les œufs, which is plural, and un œuf that is singular. It's spelled the same way, just without the F. La pomme de terre. Les frites. Now with this vocab word, with les frites, they just call them fries in France. It's not a French fries. And if you want to get technical, fries are not from France. They are actually from Belgium. So really we should be calling them, we'd be calling them Belgian fries, but the French actually refers to the way that the fries are cut, not that they originated from France. La légume. Les haricots verts. Le maïs. Les petits pois. Le chou-fleur. La concombre. Une tomate. Une carotte. Des épinards. Un champignon. Le riz. Le ketchup. Ketchup is a condiment that's not very often used in France, so that's why the word is exactly the same as it is in English. Le sel. Le poivre. Le sucre. La glace. Now, la glace means ice cream, but it also means ice, and it also could be used to talk about a mirror. So you want to make sure you know the context in which it's used. Le fruit. La fraise. La pomme. Le raisin. La poire. La banane. La pamplemousse. L'ananas. La cerise. Le gâteau. La boisson. L'eau. Le lait. Le soda. Now, another word that you could use with this, sometimes you can say un coca to refer to soda, but it can also be used to describe a Coke. So you could use either, but you just want to make sure you know which one that you're trying to specify. Le jus. Le café. Le thé. S'il vous plaît. That is our formal or plural form. S'il te plaît is our informal singular form. Merci. Boire. Manger. Demander. Payer. Vouloir. Avoir besoin. Prendre. Ouvrir. Fermer. Avoir faim. Avoir soif. Bien cuit. À point. Saignant. Flambé. Something with this meat cooking right here. If you're going to France and if you're going to order meat and you want to tell them like how much done you want it, you need to know that, you know, in France they cook their meat less than they do in the United States. So if you're going to order meat and you're going to order it rare, like it's going to be more rare than it would be in the United States. If you want something that's anything similar to what we would have in the United States, you're going to want it bien cuit. Just because otherwise you're probably not going to get your meat as well done as you would like it unless you like it more on the rare side. So feel free. That's the end of our vocab list. So feel free to watch this video as many times as you'd like so that you can get the pronunciation down. So you can practice for your speaking assignments and be ready when the time comes for your assigned speaking time. You can also ask me questions about this before, during, or after class. You can also email me with questions or submit a comment underneath the video. And I will see you in class.